The Switch is a marvellous little thing, isn't it? As well as bridging the gap between handheld and console remarkably smoothly, it's pretty much the perfect console to introduce to those who don't call themselves gamers, which is evidenced by the best Switch co-op games, whether that's online or from the comfort of your couch. Arguably one of the best platforms to play co-op games on, the Switch's detachable Joy-Cons means that it doesn't even have to be from your couch where you fight back the hordes, build a giant monument to Waluigi, wah, or cook a lot of bad food with a friend. It could be anywhere. If you're searching for the ultimate co-op games to play on the Switch, here's our picks for what will either bring you and your partner together or tear you apart irrevocably forever. Number 10, Diablo 3. Despite being so simple, the Diablo series is devilishly, addictive. This is all there is to it. Drop in, slash away, get the loot, drop out, give them your money. You'd be hard-pressed to say it has much more depth than that, despite the hordes of loot there is to collect, but Blizzard have made such a simple loop so satisfying that it's hard to resist, especially when you have friends in tow for all the hacking plus slashing. Whether from the comfort of your couch or online, co-op in Diablo 3 allows players to choose from 7 different classes as they take on this dark fantasy dungeon crawler. That said, the port is quite pricey for a game this old, so maybe hold out for a bit of a price drop. Number 9, Luigi's Mansion 3. Luigi's Mansion 3 surprised plenty of people when it came out, even more so when they revealed that Nintendo didn't actually develop it. It has every pixel of Nintendo quality that you'd come to expect. Following Luigi's escapades in a creepy hotel after his nearest and dearest are captured and kept in patents, I mean whatever's your kink mate, a second player can take the form of Guigi. As well as boasting a simply great name, Guigi can get into places that the fully solid Luigi cannot. What a loser. On top of that, up to 8 players can combine forces to take on the Scarescraper mode, which is basically the game's version of Bloody Palace, without half as much swordplay. Shame, we'd love to see Luigi rocking the Rebellion one day. Make it happen, please. And number 8, Enter the Gungeon. Something of an indie favourite, Enter the Gungeon isn't a Switch co-op game that's going to be easy going, even with an additional player. Notoriously difficult, Enter the Gungeon asks you to shoot your way through dozens of dastardly sprites as you look for a legendary gun that can kill the past. Cool. If that sounds just a little bit irreverent, that's Enter the Gungeon in a nutshell, though its silliness does belie just how difficult it can be. The deaths really tot up in this dungeon crawler. Let's not talk about those bosses either. They really can undo a good run in seconds, like a serial killer going after joggers in a park. Enlist the help of a pal as you descend the game's daft, ever-changing depths and share the pain together. And number 7, it's Overcooked 2. Now here's one of those games that could make even the strongest of couples split or ruin Christmas for the whole family. Overcooked 2 is designed to be a game that makes its players screech and wail in frustration. It's tasking with cooking food in ever more ridiculous situations. If you thought the original Overcooked was silly, you haven't really seen anything yet. Whether online or locally, and both modes work pretty well, it has to be said. Prepare to resent your loved ones when they mess up the order for the 5th time in a row. Listen, Deborah, I don't care if we're in a hot air balloon plummeting to the earth. The people deserve their Caesar salad. And coming in at number 6, it's Rayman Legends. It's baffling that Ubisoft haven't yet made a new Rayman game following the universal love shown to 2013's Legends. It's just baffling. It really is one of the best platformer games ever made, it bubbling with personality and charm. It's also great for some co-op action on your Switch, the entirety of the game's wonderful campaign playable with up to 3 friends. Packed with tons of things to collect and adorable critters to marvel at, Rayman Legends may be the definitive Switch game for younger players. But seriously, though, where's the next Rayman game? At this point, I would take an appearance in something like Rainbow Six over nothing, Brawlhalla. Actually, you know what? I would die for Rayman in Rainbow Six. Imagine being able to yeet his floaty hands at someone defusing the bomb, that would be brilliant, that. Into the top 5 though, and at number 5, it's Snipperclips. Poor old Snipperclips. Releasing as an unknown new IP at the Switch's launch when everyone was too busy battling through Breath of the Wild, is a joyful game that few people seem to talk about these days. But they really, really should. Snipperclips is a wonderfully creative game that asks you to cut paths into levels to help you and your co-op partner progress. Imagine Tearaway, but for the Switch, and you kind of have the right idea, kind of. It's a fantastically fun game for all ages that even asks you to cut shapes out of each other to open up new routes by creating shapes, or maybe just for fun. Don't sleep on snippet clips. You can leave one through switch where it is though. That's the bin, by the way. Leave it in the bin. The milking still haunts my dreams. Or the milking. Entering at number 4 is the very underrated Adventure Pals. You might take one look at Adventure Pals' beautiful art style and wonder why more people don't talk about it as one of the best platformers around. Well, it is quite short, easily beatable in a lazy afternoon. Still though, if it's a light distraction you want to enjoy with a co-op partner who maybe doesn't play too many games, the Adventure Pals is basically a classic Saturday morning cartoon that you can play through in the same amount of time, all with a big smile on your face. As if you needed any more reason to check out the Adventure Pals on your Switch, you can ride a giraffe. Can The Last of Us do that? Can it? No? Checkmate. And coming in at number 3, Heave Ho. No, sadly it's nothing to do with Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Could get the rights. Farcical limbs based party games are all the rage these days, and Heave Ho is perhaps the most farcical, but in a good way, of them all. By controlling the arms of your strange ball goblin thingy while working together with friends, you can make your way across some increasingly bizarre levels with gimmicks aplenty. There's even the ability to play as other Devolver characters. Sounds easy? Well, it's not. Whether your co-op partner is getting in your way and sending you plummeting to your death, or you miss a ledge by a single pixel after they throw you across the whole level, Heave Ho is one of the most challenging yet hilarious games you can find on the Switch. It's almost always available on the cheap nowadays as well, so it's definitely something worth checking out if you haven't. Coming at number 2, just missing out the top spot, it's Minecraft. Please don't kill me. At this point in its illustrious life, there's a high chance you've already played Minecraft, long decided whether or not it's really a game for you. Not everyone loves it, but those who do love it are borderline obsessed with it. Alright, so maybe not borderline, maybe full on living inside a box obsessed with it, maybe that. The freedom of creativity and exploration are just two of the main reasons why Minecraft has so many fans, as well as its accessibility to players of all ages. If you want to build a monument to Reggie, why not enlist the help of a friend? Maybe even Reggie will play with you, he's a very nice man. Better yet, thanks to the game's crossplay support, one of the most robust in all of gaming, you can play with all of your friends over different platforms. Minecraft really is one of those games that crops up on so many lists so often, but it's recognition it truly deserves. Now please leave me alone for not putting it on the best survival games list, okay? I messed up! And coming in at number 1, it's Cuphead. Let's finish things off with a Switch co-op game that will make even a professional gamer family, imagine such a thing existed, Jim, question their skill. Cuphead is one of the most difficult yet immensely rewarding games of the last 10 years, and it's right at home on the Switch. This side-scrolling bullet hell allows two players to take the reins of the eponymous Cuphead and Mugman as they look to pay off a debt to the devil himself. If anything, the game is even harder with two players, the game balancing to punish you for daring to look for the easier way out, you coward. If you can wipe away the frustration sweats and get past the notoriously impossible tutorial, Cuphead offers one of the most gorgeous art styles out there with a simple yet maddeningly addictive gameplay to match. Don't play it with your mum though, unless you want to hear the woman who birthed you say some very unsavoury things about crockery. Ugh. So that was our list of the best Switch co-op games. Let me know what I'm missing. I know there's a lot I'm probably missing. This is just the top 10 of things we've been playing and enjoying lately. Be sure to drop a comment down below, to the left or the right, or wherever the hell they're putting these things these days. And if you would like and subscribe, that would be very good. And thank you for watching. Stay cool.